This is Luke Paulson, the Catholic Conservative, and welcome to the news of the week for March 18th, 2023. And if you enjoy these videos, do not forget to like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe for more. Met Gala ticket was a gift. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez wore a controversial dress to the Met Gala. And by controversial, I mean a blanket statement that is the basis of her party. Instead of cutting spending, Democrats and rhinos just want to take more of our money to fund excessive programs. Now, while I do not care about anything that these celebrities would do, I have a problem when the rules are not applied equally. According to the Federal Elections Commission, this member of the squad did not properly disclose this degree of income. The tickets are normally $35,000. So she met a bunch of people that could have just written checks to help the poor instead. Instead, she wants you and me to pay to help the poor in other countries like Ukraine.
Pre-war, you know, the Ukrainian government is one of the worst in the world. Mm. You know, corrupt, controlled by a few rich people. I mean, really unfortunate for the people in Ukraine.
Conservatives are trying to get her on a House ethics violation charge, but I doubt anything will come of it. However, I am not done talking about this now privileged woman just yet. Suing over a Twitter block.
AOC, my favorite big booty Latina. I love you, AOC, you're my favorite. She wants to kill babies, but she's still beautiful. You look very beautiful in that dress. You look very sexy. Look at that booty on AOC. That's my favorite big booty Latina. I love it. My favorite, AOC. Nice to meet you, AOC. Look how sexy she looks in that dress. Ooh, I love it, AOC. Hot, hot, hot like a tamale.
Alex Stein, better known as Primetime 99 or the Pimp on a Blimp, is suing AOC after she blocked him on Twitter.
Hey, everybody. I'm here in the Capitol. See this guy right there?
Shake, 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 Sonora. Shake him out of line. Shake, shake, shake.
He, when I was walking up, he said, hey, right in front of a Capitol Police officer, hey, here's this, look at that big ass, look at that big juicy booty, this Latina, like whatever.
Not too long ago, several people whom President Trump blocked on Twitter sued him to be able to view his tweets. Their argument was simple. His Twitter account essentially amounted to his discourse with the American people as president. The lawsuit went through, and President Trump unblocked those that he blocked. Now Alex Stein is suing on the same grounds. A duly elected representative blocked him on Twitter, and thus he cannot see her statements as a public servant. I am not from California, but I am still affected by every decision that Speaker McCarthy makes. I am also not from New York, but I am still affected by every decision that AOC makes. If they were senators that only made decisions for California and New York respectively, they could probably get away with blocking a Texan. However, we need to be able to see what the people that we are paying are up to. If Mr. Stein succeeds, it will set a precedent, and politicians will no longer be able to block people on social media. COVID documents declassified. Imagine how nervous certain people are that all of the documents related to the China virus might be declassified. The House of Representatives unanimously passed a resolution to declassify all documents related to the origin of the virus. We already know that the National Institute of Allergies and Infectious Diseases, headed by flip-flop Fauci, funded research in Wuhan. The FBI and several other agencies have admitted that this lab was the most likely origin of the virus. It now goes to Brandon's desk, where he will sign and open the floodgates, or he will veto it and send it back to the two chambers where a lot of Democrats will suddenly change their votes. Remember when Republicans voted unanimously to repeal Obamacare multiple times, knowing that it would fail?
Pepperidge Farm remembers.
They were just trying to score political points back home, because the rhinos did not care one way or the other if we peasants were suffering. I predict the same thing here. There might not be enough to override the veto, but we cannot give up hope. If all of the conspiracy theorists are right, and we usually are, this was a biological weapon from China. How would the U.S. respond if the Chinese army started shooting people on American soil? To be fair, Democrats would probably blame the gun, but I digress. More documents found. Do you remember the small pile of documents that the FBI was able to seize from the safe at Mar-a-Lago that they said was secure?
Pepperidge Farm remembers.
Now we know that there were at least 9 boxes of documents found with Joe Biden's personal attorney in Boston. Probably not locked away anywhere, and probably just sitting in a storeroom. The National Archives learned that the boxes were moved from Penn State to the lawyers' offices on November 3, 2022. This means that they had to be moved sometime prior. The raid at Mar-a-Lago happened in early August. I suspect that these documents were moved just after the raid to keep them out of the public eye so that Brandon would stay squeaky clean. So locked away in a safe necessitates a SWAT team, but in an office at a college or of a lawyer necessitates a phone call. This is the world in which we live. School forbids Christians. Language is a powerful thing, and if you can rewrite language, you can change how people see the world. Take the word homophobia as an example. No one at all who is accused of this is scared of sodomites in the least. It is just a rewriting of language to say that anyone who supports God's definition of marriage must just be hateful. As such, I take you to Arizona, where the Washington Elementary School District has decided that a college that takes a biblical stance is a threat to the safety of its students. What did this college do, you might ask? This school, Arizona Christian University, holds to biblical marriage. That is all. And for some reason, the board thinks that this is violence. ACU has had a relationship with the schools in the district for the past 11 years to allow their student teachers to go to the classrooms and teach. At a time when there is a shortage of teachers, this is the hill that the school board is willing to die on. Luckily, the Alliance Defending Freedom has taken this to court. The state may not prohibit the free exercise of religion, something that this board has forgotten. We will see what happens. Michigan will not protect Christians. Michigan lawmakers took time out of their busy schedules to add LGBT protections to a civil rights law. Republican lawmakers tried to add protections for Christians, especially after the FBI was targeting Catholics. But it failed in the name of inclusivity. Governor Whitmer will undoubtedly sign it. As a result, anyone in Michigan can be sued for not hiring someone based on their perceived identity. Even if someone like this...
Hey kids! Hi kids! I want to talk to the kids. Hey kids! Hi kids! Hey kids! Hi! It's good for children to see LGBTQ lives. Your parents screwed up.
Wants to be near children. It does not matter in the name of inclusion. There is a culture war at play and battle lines are being drawn. While some states are protecting children, other states are trying to protect people who can only claim oppression. The future of American banking. The Silicon Valley Bank crashed, and I am so concerned. Sorry, I got bored there and stopped caring. This bank made countless risky loans and investments, including $74 million to Black Lives Matter and businesses whose only selling point was that they checked intersectionality boxes. 2 other banks failed due to their own risky investments. When several members of the auto industry failed, Congress was quick to bail them out with our money. The elites did the same thing here. This will be paid for by just printing more money. You and I will suffer the mistakes of companies going woke, rather than the other way around. James O'Keefe is back. Project Veritas got rid of James O'Keefe, possibly because the board was infiltrated by Big Pharma, but no one can prove that. He promised that he would not remain silent, but we had to wait and see. Now he has revealed O'Keefe Media Group, which he describes as citizen journalists working together. O'Keefe described it as Uber for journalism. The goal is to get a camera in every school board and every city council office in America. A sleeping giant has been awoken.
Maybe I'm just blowing smoke. Maybe I'm completely off my rocker, but that is just my opinion.
And if you enjoyed this content, do not forget to like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe for more.
And also don't forget to follow me on social media.